Anyway, I don't know. I just feel like talking. It's just been an awful day. Awful day. Started out with the cable missing from the cell phone, and then it just escalated to no, I don't have a boyfriend, I don't have dates, and it just went on and on and on, and I just flipped out that I'm spinster, I'm just a spinster here, and I blame my family, I blame everybody who knows my entrance here from France. I've been here. I don't know anybody. I don't have any friends. And all these people lived here their whole lives. And they just abandoned me to this situation. So yeah. They just abandoned me to absolute isolation. With my elderly father. He's criminal. Absolutely criminal. You live your lives, you know, here. You know people here. You could have set me up on a date. You don't do this to your sister, you don't do this to your friend. So yeah, I guess not. I guess I have no friends. So anyhoot, yeah, it's been a terrible day. This whole drama with switching from trying to switch out of this sing-along diva voice, you know, because I had, oh my god, I had a repertoire, pretty good, I wasn't great with the words, but, you know, about 70 songs, you know, 70 arias, it's a lot of arias that I could just hit and sing, and then now I'm like, oh crud, you know, it's like back to the drawing board, you know, I'm looking at, you know, I know, I was never gonna have the aims of being a performing singer. That wasn't the deal, I was just gonna be recording. But the point is, now I'm in this. Now I'm like looking for a cellist or an oboe player or a clarinet. Perhaps then, you know, maybe that'll be a perfect match for me, somebody who plays the clarinet or the cello. You know, you can make music that way, you know. I don't know, I'm too distraught. I'm too distraught with this situation of isolation. Alright, so back to singing. Okay, I'll tell you my drama fall. Coming out I've lost the drama from my getting into the dramatics. I can't get into those. I just have lost the nerves for it, you know. That pounce into the song. I've lost it. So I'm not sure why, but it's just like the very beginning. It's almost like I have to go back to like where they are in college, and they're singing like the little tiny songs, you know, in the upper range. You know, I have to go back to that range, and then into legato, and then into these dramas, but the dramatics are just kicking me out right now, so yeah, it's a pretty awful thing. Pretty awful thing. Anyway, so yeah, I mean, nobody really wants to go through this, ever. I don't do it, I don't advise it. Because I do, I have a huge ego for my consumption of what I can do there with the recording, with the recorded voice out. You know, I have tremendous skill, I have tremendous power. But then it's just like, it's a real sad situation. So yeah, it's very emotional time extra. Very emotional. And anyway, did I give another business out? Do we need another business? Yeah, I went with like a record museum. That would be a good idea. Would be pretty much a huge building with records on the wall, and you walk around it like the Louvre, and there it is, a record and a record and a record and a record. And so there's the Latin room, and there's the country western wing, and there over there is the blues. And then you go into that room and you look at all of the record album covers, you know. That's it, you know. And then you go into this other room and you look at all the record album covers. And I guess there could be assorted, you know, areas you can actually hear the songs. You know, listen, you know, like they do at the Virgin Megastore, you can actually hear the songs. Yeah, so there could be that type of a deal. Where you actually could hear the songs also. From your favorite oldies or whatever. But yeah. Because the albums themselves are works of art, we already know this, and they're just things that are just never going to happen again. You look at CDs, and they're just like these little miniature things, and then we're not even using CDs so much anymore. Now we just want to just buy, even just like a little tiny, you know, just the MP3, like the USB, could you just give me the song as the USB? That would be better, you know. But so we're losing, you know, that big drama of the album cover, you know, it's just not there. So the museum itself would be kind of cool. I don't know where you would put such a thing, but yeah, not in Memphis, not in the towns of already done deluxe on one guy. What's his name? Elvis. Yeah, they probably would like an Elvis room. But no, that's the whole point, you know. It would be just instead of just the albums, you know, stacked up together, you'd actually see them in their square, their huge squares. So yeah, that, I don't know. I kind of like that idea. I think that would be a visitor museum. You get a lot of people going. People travel the world even to see that, to go, wow, go to the record museum. You know, something to do. So yeah, so it's a tourist biz. I don't know. So I'll drop that one out there. Yeah, I don't know. And I'm greedy with these songs. I'm greedy. I want them all back. I want all of the what I had in my repertoire back, and I want it now. And that's just the way it goes. And I don't have it. I don't have it. So it's just it's like a real fall from a great cliff. Anyway, I'll talk another time.